Dr. Pettigrew, you stop by and got some coffee for me.
Good, thanks. Where you been?
Well, I stopped by the chapel. I guess to say a prayer of thanks.
Oh, Ruby, it's a miracle. I keep on saying to myself over and over again that he's alive. And I just feel like I'm so filled with joy, I want to explode.
I know. I've always said God works in mysterious ways, but this time, it's a miracle.
You know, I have been thinking of something that Robert said when we were up in Dan's office, though. He said that Luke is going to need time and space to work this out.
I think he's right. He must be in agony.
Ruby, he needs us.
Then why doesn't he call us?
I don't know. I've been thinking about that. The only thing I can come up with is he's so crushed and so devastated he can't function.
And what you said before is true. He has never needed us as much before in his life.
And we can't wait for him to come to us, Ruby. We have to go and find him.
How?
Well, I think we can assume he's somewhere in Port Charles, and I think we just have to start looking.
We'll comb the city.
That's right. We're going to call everybody we know, and we are going to keep on calling. We'll keep on looking until we find him.
And the sooner the better. And he'd better have a good reason why he didn't let us know he was alive.
For the life of me, I can't figure out what that reason was.
Well, I'm sure it wasn't a happy one. He must have been in torment.
He still is.
Yes, and alone. Oh, honey, we've got to find him and let him know he's not alone.